departmental requirements, check country specific requirements. The requirements for Cameroonians is different for Nigerian students, and of course different for Pakistanis, Chinese students and Vietnamese students, and also for Egyptians and Algerians. So when you are applying for a university in Norway, always check country specific requirements, check departmental requirements and general requirements, all right, so as to be informed of what you need to do. The second yes, welcome back, beautiful people. Thank you so much for joining today. Thank you. If you are new on this platform, this is the Anointing Village YouTuber. My name is Milton Fonkwa. For my returning subscribers, I want to equally say I'm so grateful for you coming back to the platform. Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about studies in the Norwegian University of Science and Technology, okay, which is commonly called NTNU, all right? It is a private institution, sorry, a public institution in Norway. And we all know that Norway is one of the leading countries in Northern Europe, okay, with a high rate of employment and also a high living standard, okay. In essence, what I'm trying to say is Norway is a country where cost of living is very expensive, okay. But that is not only a disadvantage, it is still an advantage for international students who are moving to Norway, because they are going to be studying for free, okay. Universities, state universities in Norway are actually free tuition, all right. You don't pay anything. After your admissions, you just need to accept your position and you move to Norway and study, okay. You are not paying any tuition fee. No, so essentially Norway is like education in Norway is same like that in Germany in some sense, because some German universities too, I think about 80% of German universities are actually free tuition. So international students tend to crowd these destinations because of the advantages in terms of tuition fee payment, all right? Because if I'm the one, of course, I am going to be moving to such countries because it is advantageous for me saving more money. Now, today, let's talk about the Norwegian University of Science and Technology. The Norwegian University of Science and Technology is an institution with three campuses. And the first campus is found in Trondheim. The second campus is found in Alesson. And the third campus is found in Gjøvik, all right? Please do not bother about the pronunciation. Do not worry about the spellings. Everything I'm mentioning on this channel is going to be in the video description, okay? So do check the video description and make sure you send a message to me. Put a comment in the comment section if you do have a problem. And now, with three campuses at the Norwegian University of Science and Technology, it is advantageous for international students not to crowd a certain particular destination, all right? Because now the courses are distributed according to these campuses. Now, let's talk about the admissions first. Admissions in Norway usually runs from October to December. Most of the times in most universities, though some few universities extend their admissions to January and February. But I will advise you as an international who is trying to share knowledge, if you want to apply for a Norwegian university, their application portal usually opens from 1st of October and closes to on 1st of December, all right, most of them. So since it is tuition free, I guarantee you that a lot of international students will of course be applying for this same country, so you have a competition to face. So if you are applying, make sure that sorry guys for the yawning, if you are applying, make sure that you apply as early as possible so that you do not miss a position. Remember, admission is competitive, okay? Now, because of these three campuses, there is something I want to mention again. Admissions in Norwegian universities is carried out online, okay, using a particular website called or a particular portal called Sonak Web. It is going to be in the video description, so please check it out. At Sonak Web, again, when you finish applying or putting your details at Sonak Web, you also need to understand that there is no send button on Sonak Web. When you finish applying, okay, as soon as you put your information, it goes directly to the institution. There is no send button, which means that when you put the information and upload your documents, just leave it like that. It has already gone to the institution, but there is a date in which you can come back and reshuffle your your application, which means that you, if you think something is not correct or you want to update your application, you can come back and reshuffle your application, all right? So now, for the documents you will be needing, first of all, let me talk about the courses. The courses are distributed according to these three campuses, and at the Alesson campus, all right, English taught bachelor's programs include IT, automation, business and marketing, all right, life sciences. While master's taught master's programs at Alesson campus include international business and marketing, MSc in product and business as well, MSc in ship design, okay, MSc in simulation and visualization. So basically, if you are an artist or a scientist, you can as well look for this university or check it out, because I think it has a program somewhere hidden in one of the campuses somewhere for you to study, okay? Now, the courses taught at the Gigovic campus include, for bachelor's in English language, include computer sciences, okay, designs, and some other languages, all right? Though you are being taught in English language, but remember, you can study the Norwegian language, then you proceed to another degree program, which is taught in English language. Then master's courses include computer sciences, computer technology, information security, all right, interactions and design, sustainable manufacturing, and of course, if you are doing a master's, you are going to do a thesis at the end of the year, and a master's courses ends in 2 years' time, all right. If you want to apply for a master's degree program in Norway, know that you are going to be studying for 2 years, but bachelor's degree students have to study for 4 years, okay. Then, now, for the application documents, you need a transcript. For please, if you are an international student who wants to apply to Norway, know that you have to prepare your documents and start your admissions, your application process by October 1st, especially at the Norwegian University of Science and Technology, all right? And also bear in mind that it has three campuses. And if you want to apply, the first document you need is your transcript. And this transcript has to be an official transcript signed by the competent authorities in your university. This is in case you are applying for a master's degree program, because bachelor's degree students, of course, are going to apply only for programs using their high school certificate. So if you are applying for a master's program, you need a transcript, and this transcript has to be an official transcript, okay? If it is in another language, or let me say for those students who are, for Chinese citizens, for Pakistanis, I think, and other students whose transcripts are not in English language, please translate it into English, all right, before you do your admissions. And again, before I forget, when you are doing your admission process to any Norwegian university, please always check departmental requirements, check country-specific requirements. The requirements for Cameroonians is different for Nigerian students, and of course, different for Pakistanis, Chinese students, and Vietnamese students, and also for Egyptians and Algerians. So when you are applying for a university in Norway, always check country-specific requirements, check departmental requirements and general requirements, all right, so as to be informed of what you need to do. The second type of document you need is your passport identification page, the page on your passport which shows your details, your name, your surname, your date of birth, and your picture, all right. You also need it when you are doing an application to a Norwegian school. And make sure that your passport is 6 months plus, all right, in order for your stuff to be processed well. Now, you also do need a document of English proficiency. In this case, you can submit an IELTS or a TOEFL, but always pay consideration or always bear in mind or always keep in contact with what has been written on the website of the school you are applying for, because they can say we need a total band score of 6, 6.5 or 7, and if you do not meet this band score, please do not apply, because remember, Norwegian universities don't need a lot of students. Sometimes a master's class is maximum 20, certain programs maybe 15, some 30. So remember again that it is free tuition, so you have a competition to face, all right? But in as much as you have faith, always try to apply, all right? So what I'm basically saying is always look at the requirements very well. You can also use the TOEFL or the Cambridge exam. There is another exam written in the United Kingdom called the Cambridge exam, so you can as well use that one. Then the other thing you need again is a CV. They might ask for your CV. Remember, if they say a short CV and provide them with one page of your CV, all right? And don't always always avoid this thing of making your CV more than 2 pages, okay? Because it is going to look nasty and not clean. Again, remember, as I said, there are country-specific requirements and there are departmental requirements. If you go to the country-specific requirements of Cameroon, and most universities in Norway will need you to submit a bank statement at the application stage. Then after you get the admission, you also submit the money that was indicated on that bank statement. Alright, so Nigerian students, always check your requirements in terms of your country. Pakistani, Nigerians, Cameroonians, Ghanaians, okay, Algerians, Egyptians, Chinese students, they have different requirements, okay? And most of the times this school will tell you that take your documents to this place and certify them. This person should be the one to certify your documents, and you do like this, you do like that. So always check the requirements, okay? Then when you apply, you upload your documents, and I will advise you always convert your documents as early as possible to PDF files, okay, or to PDF copies. That is the best way to upload documents when you are applying for a university. And check again if they say combine the PDF, combine all your certificates to one PDF file. Make sure it is in one PDF file. If they don't say that, you can upload single files. And again, if you have been asked to mail the documents or hard copies or certified hard copies, make sure you follow instructions and follow the address given to you, all right? So after the admissions, what you need again to do is you have to accept your position. Remember, in Norway, you must accept your position. Since you will be putting some money in a block account, all right, and the money has increased. Initially, it was 121,000 plus Norwegian krone, but now it's 123,000 plus Norwegian krone. If you don't know about this information, please watch my previous videos. I have other videos on my channel talking about studies in Norway, so you can watch them so that you know what is required. All right, I have a lot of videos on my channel. Please go check my content. I have great content for you. Then when you have the admission, if your documents are okay, everything is okay, and you meet the requirements, maybe the school is going to accept you. And if they give you an admission, they will tell you you have this specific date or this particular date to confirm your spot and this particular date to put the money in your account and you apply for your visa, okay? So that is what you need to know. Then after that, you are going to apply for the visa. The Norwegian University of Science and Technology, among other universities like the Norwegian University of Life Sciences, the University of Stavanger, the University of Oslo, the University of Bergen, the Nord University, all right, the University of Tromsø, are very good institution, or is a good institution you can study in alongside these other schools I am mentioning to you. Remember, not all universities in Norway have bachelor's taught programs in English language, all right? There are very few of them. If I remember vividly, the Norway University and the University of Tromsø, I think they have few bachelor's programs taught in English language, as well as the Norwegian University of Science and Technology. So if you are one international student who want to make a change in your life, please consider applying when it's October of 2021, because applications will open by October 2021. If you check now, if you try to apply now, it won't go, because I know what I'm saying, all right? So thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. If you find this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe below, all right? Subscribe so that we can be family and create the, build the platform together. Thank you so much, guys, and until we meet again in another one, peace.